Welcome to another session of the subject Harbor Engineering. We are studying chapter number 2, that is Harbor Planning. In the previous sessions, we have studied about the functions and uses of various harbor components. So now we will be continuing from that point onwards. Up till now, we have studied each and every harbor component briefly, that is the function and use in isolation. Now we shall study how those functions or uses are incorporated in the harbor as a whole. That is how the function and uses of its components are set in such a manner that they work in cohesion or coordination with each other. So now this is a very important figure from exam point of view, from the subject point of view, and more importantly from understanding point of view, in which all the components have been shown. So let's discuss the function of each component and their specific location, that is why they have been placed at the location which has been specified in the drawing. Repeating again, this is a very important sketch from exam point of view, understanding point of view of the subject as well. Firstly is the entrance channel from which ship will enter into the harbor. So it is, as the name suggests, in the entrance part. Next is the jetty, which is inclined or perpendicular to the shore. It can be inside the harbor or it can be outside the harbor. Here jetty is placed outside the harbor and it handles the petroleum products, those products which are not very heavy. So all those products can be loaded, unloaded on the jetty. Next is pierhead, which is in connection with the breakwater. As we can see on the periphery is the breakwater. It is connected with the breakwater, and basically on the pierhead navigational aids can be mounted. We'll be studying about navigational aids in detail in the upcoming sessions. Next, and the most important, is breakwater, which is on the circumference or the periphery and which will dissipate the wave energy or wind energy and make sure that the portion which is inside the circumference will remain in calm state, so that the operations which are going to be carried out in the harbor will be carried out safely. Next is a turning basin, as the word used is turning. So basically it is the space or area which is provided for the maneuvering operation. That is, when a ship enters the harbor, this is the space or area which is provided so that the turning operation can take place and the ship can move towards the loading and unloading platform, that is pier or quay or wharf. Sheltered basin is basically that area which is protected by the breakwater. So this is, as a whole, a sheltered basin, the area which is protected by the breakwater. Now, next are the loading and unloading platforms, that is piers, quay, wharf. All these loading and unloading platforms are not provided at a harbor. Depending upon the situation, any one or two of these loading and unloading platforms are provided. So piers, as we know, are perpendicular to the shore, while quay and bar are parallel to the shore. So that we can see here, function of all are the same, as I already said. Difference between quay and bar, we know quay is a retaining earth structure which is not present in bar. Piers basically are provided to handle the cargo which has heavy tonnage. So difference between jetty and pier is that piers can handle heavy tonnage, heavy cargo with reference to jetty. Next are the dry dock, wet dock. Dry dock are provided for carrying out the repair or maintenance work, and in this portion the lock gates will be provided which will be retaining the water. Wet dock, that will allow the passage of water, and basically here the loading and unloading of cargo can be carried out. Terminal building is basically to see the monitoring or the functioning of the harbor, that it is functioning smoothly or is there any sort of an issue or problem to be handled. Shed is the transit shed, which is always placed adjacent to the loading unloading structure. So as soon as the cargo is unloaded, on the quay or any loading unloading structure such as pier or wharf, then it is directly passed on to the transit shed, which is for temporary storage. And next, warehouse also can be provided if the materials have to be stored for a long period of time. And lastly, workshop, that is related to the sort of instruments which can be placed in any sort of repair work which has to be done with reference to the machineries. So basically, these are the functions of each and every harbour components, and here the figure reflects that the components are placed in such a manner that their purpose is satisfied and are placed in cohesion with each other. That is, as I give an example of quay and transit shed, they should be placed adjacent so that as soon as the cargo is unloaded, it can be transferred into the storage area. So this is a very important sketch. Next, again a figure representing the various harbour components. Again, in short, we will be going through these components. First is the entrance channel, that is for entering the harbour. Breakwater is the periphery or circumference for dissipating the wind and wave energy. Jetty, that is perpendicular to the shore for handling the low weight cargo. Small boat harbour, that is a small space or area which is provided specifically for small boats. Anchorage area, that is the area of space which is provided for tying up of the ship. Anchorage means to tie up. Turning basin, that is the space or area provided for the maneuvering operation. So again, these are the basic few components of the harbour which we have studied for revision purpose. Now we will be studying another important topic from exam point of view, that is the difference between wharf and jetty. Up to now, we already know the function of wharf and jetty and how they are placed in the harbour, that also we are aware about. So now let us discuss the differences between them. So firstly, this is the view of wharf, which is parallel to the shore, and here as we can see that the loading and unloading can be carried out on one side only. Next is the jetty, which is perpendicular to the shore, and here the loading and unloading of cargo can be carried out on both the sides. So first is the direction, that is perpendicular to the shore, and here on both the sides the loading and unloading of cargo can be done, which was not the case in wharf. It was only a single sided loading and unloading platform. So basically, these are the differences. First, wharf, which is parallel to the shore, as we can see it is parallel. Next, jetty is perpendicular to the shore. This is the perpendicular direction. It has berth on one side and earth retained on other side. That is, here as we can see that berthing can be done on one side only. Berthing means to give accommodation, and on the other side there will be earth, that is soil. Here jetty, as you can see, it can be berthed on both the sides. So this is a important difference between wharf and jetty. So I hope it is clear. Next are the requirements or characteristics of a good harbour. So basically, this topic means that for a harbour to be called as a good harbour, what requirements should it satisfy or what characteristics it should have. So let us go through the characteristics. First is that it should be connected by roadway and railway for faster transportation of goods. So as soon as the cargo has been unloaded through the road network or through the rail network, it can be transported wherever it is needed. So that connection link, communication link is important. Next point is regarding the channels, which is natural or artificial, should have adequate depth for movement of vessels. That is, a minimum navigable depth has to be maintained for the movement of ship, so that channel should have the adequate depth while making movement, and for that dredging operation should be carried out periodically. Breakwaters must be provided to protect against the destructive wave action. This point now we are already aware about, which is regarding the importance of breakwater, which we have already studied up to this point. For holding ships against the wave action and for providing secure anchorage, bottom should be supporting. That is to make sure that the ship isn't being taken away by the wave action. Proper anchorage, that is sort of we can say a holding facility for the ship, should be provided, and the bottom should be supportive of providing such facility. So we have to carry out the survey for the bottom as well, whether it would be able to support such load transfer for handling or for tying up the ships or not. Entrance should be wide enough to permit the easy passage. So it should be wide enough, and one must make sure that the widest ship which is likely to visit the harbor is taken into account while deciding the width of the channel, and narrow enough to restrict the transmission of waves in time of storm. So it must not be so wide so as to allow the easy transmission of waves which might sort of create hindrance during the loading unloading operation. So it must be wide enough to allow the widest ship to enter, but not that much wide so as to allow the easy transmission of waves which might create a hindrance during the operation or the loading unloading work in the harbor. Should have sufficient number of quay, piers, bar for loading unloading of cargo. This point we are already aware about the functions. So depending upon the cargo to be handled, the tonnage of cargo to be handled, the amount of quay, piers or bar should be decided. Also, adequate number of transit shed for storage of cargo, that is it will depend upon the cargo, amount of cargo to be handled. Facilities for repairing and fueling for vessels should be provided, that is for repair work of the vessels or for the fueling operation of vessels, facility should be there. Area should be adequately large enough. In case of fishing harbor, enough cold storage should be provided. So basically, while handling the fishery products, we have to maintain a minimum temperature, that is a sort of range of temperature has to be maintained, which is very low temperature. So the cold storages are provided for storage of such fishery products. So it is a sort of facility which is essential while handling the fishery in the fishing harbor.